So what is agile testing? Well, in this video, we're going to find out, and I'm going to give you a common sense overview based on experience of working as an agile coach and consultant. All right, so welcome to this series of videos on agile testing. We're going to look at the kind of theory and thought processes and to help us understand it, because when we're working on an agile project, we need to have a massive amount of flexibility and tailoring what we do. So I'm going to start by going through a kind of slide deck that I created, which answers the 9 common questions about agile testing. And this one, we're going to cover the first one. What is agile testing? Now, people get hung up on this. For some reason, they make it very, very complicated. I'm going to get a mind map up and we're going to use that to discuss this a little bit. One thing that agile testing is not is a noun. So when we say, what is agile testing? It's not a thing. It's not, you can't buy a bunch of agile testing. What it is, it's a verb, it's an approach, it's a process. It is how we test on an agile project. It's the stuff we do and the way we think, but it's on an agile project. That's the only thing that makes it different from any other test approach, the fact that we are testing on an agile project. That seems kind of tautological, that seems obvious, but for some reason people make it hard, and it's not a new thing, as we're going to find out, because people get hung up on the words, and they get hung up on the words because they don't really understand what the words meant before. They didn't really understand what testing meant before, so agile testing seems like it's a new thing. Fundamentally, agile processes are adaptive in their organization to help people deliver functionality on an ongoing, consistent basis, meeting requirements and needs quickly because of a few trappings. It doesn't mean that the software development happens faster, it just means we meet needs and requirements faster, and testing has to respond to that, which means testing has to work differently, because previously with testing, we, in theory, knew what we were going to do in advance, so we planned for that and documented for that. Here, with Agile, we don't necessarily know what we're going to do in advance. We're going to adapt. We're going to prioritize some functionality above other functionality, and the test approach has to compensate for that, which makes it unique. And it's unique for the environment that we're working in, the particular company or the organization. And it might be different in each department in that organization. It might be different in each team in that organization. And sometimes it's different for each team member. Now, the more coherent and consistent an agile process is, the better it works. So hopefully every team member has the same view, but sometimes they don't. When we approach testing, we are very often just trying to fit into all these different viewpoints on Agile and how it works, because we're trying to mitigate risk in different ways. So what we're trying to do is fit in to that process. The test process is not a separate in parallel process that we can outsource and offshore. It is a process that merges very tightly with the programming approach, because what we've got is we've got a software development approach. One part of that software development approach is programming. One part of that software development approach is testing. They merge together to get an effective agile development process. We're trying to cover risks. I'm going to cover risks later on here, but we're very often targeting risk because sometimes the programming approach will be built to mitigate some risk. We might be doing test-driven design. We might be trying to do acceptance test-driven development. We might have a lot of processes in our normal programming process that mitigate risk. Therefore, the test approach changes because it's a different risk profile. The risk is going to be in different places in the system, so we test differently to try and accommodate that. And it's important that the approach that we take to testing on agile projects is agreed. And the reason it's important it's agreed is because testing is no longer about the tester and the tester role. It's about testing on the project. So different people can test in different ways to different levels. A tester, hopefully, can test better than other people and can test differently than other people. So we want to use those skills appropriately on the project so that they're not just spent their time covering very basic acceptance criteria, because pretty much anyone can do that. They're looking at targeted risks, system risks, more complicated approaches, longer term approaches to, I don't know, performance, security, stress testing, functional testing, technical testing, accessibility, all the parts that require a bit more skill and a testing focused thought process that requires time to build up than just the normal obvious stuff that the acceptance criteria tells us. Now, the key thing about Agile is that an Agile process is one that adapts. It will change over time as the team learn how to work together, as their system of development changes, their process will change. Their needs for what the software will deliver change. The architecture might change, the tools that we're using might change. The risk profile of the project changes as it goes forward. When it starts, we accept a lot of risk because we're trying to create something as a minimum viable product, to get something out, to validate some assumptions, to make sure we're on the right track, to fully flush out the kind of needs that the users have. But later on, we want to make it more robust. We're not as accepting of issues when the system is live. We won't accept risks because they're going out not just internally but to externally facing clients. There's money passing through the system now. The risk profile changes, so the test approach changes over time. The skills on the team will adapt over time. As the team learns to work together, knowledge transfer takes place. Programmers learn how to test better because they're working with the testers. Therefore, the amount of testing work that the programmers can do changes over time. The test approach changes and adapts. The system architecture changes. We have to learn different technical aspects in the system and how to test them, which might require testing at different levels underneath the GUI, at the API, at certain binary protocols, understanding the risk that is in place with the way that we build the interfaces. All of this changes over time, and we have to learn it and adapt to it. The time scales will change over time because we'll need functionality delivered at different points. Some functionality might span multiple iterations of releases. We have to test in a way that accommodates that. We have to test the in-progress functionality, knowing that it doesn't work completely, then test it as though it were finished. There's different stages and approaches to our test. We have to adapt. Now, that might sound complicated, but the reality is that Agile testing is simple. What we've done is we're trying to involve everyone, and we're trying to make this part of the development process, and we're trying to make this simple. And to do that, we just avoid many of the trappings that we've come to associate with software testing. So given that Agile testing is simply an approach to testing on an Agile project, we should probably look at how it's different. Now, it's not really different in the fundamentals of testing. What's different is that we've come to associate testing with a lot of process, with a lot of trappings, with a lot of paraphernalia, a lot of extras. So we strip those away and get back to the essence of testing, then we have something that can probably work better on an Agile project. So the kind of extras we're talking about are a lot of the documentation overhead. Now, they're overhead on an Agile project because an Agile project is incrementally defining what it's doing. It's making decisions as it goes along. It doesn't know in advance everything that it's going to do or what it's going to try and aim for. Therefore, a lot of big documents to explain exactly what you're going to cover at certain points is not required anymore. These kind of documents are a response to a development process that required them because it was doing a lot of things in advance. And testing is very often a response to the development process, to the regulatory requirements that we have in place, to the management process, to the reports that they need or want, or organizational hierarchy that we're going through is. Agile changes all of that. So we should expect the process, the trappings, to change as well. We're no longer offshoring it, hopefully, because we're trying to get the team to work together tightly. We're changing the way that the team are organized so they all work very closely together. All of that changes the extras that we have to do. There's a much greater requirement for verbal communication, for taking responsibility for pointing out risks and problems at the time that they happen. We don't need a lot of documentation. That doesn't mean we don't do any. Right. I think it's still important to describe the decisions that we make and write those down, because they help us evaluate if we've done enough later on. I think it's still important for us when we do our testing to document what we've done. It's important to document the ideas we have in advance, if we have ideas in advance, because there's no point keeping all this stuff in our head, because then you're the only person that can do it and we're trying to spread the load. So trying to write things down is still important, but it doesn't mean we need a test management tool. We can use whatever tools that we're using to track our project. If we're doing everything in text files and uploading to GitHub, then that's where we document our testing. If we're using Jira for everything, then that's where we document our testing. Whatever we're doing as part of the software development process, we use in our software testing process. We don't add extras that are not actually required for the team. And if we have a lot of extras that are being asked for because of organizational concerns, we should probably be trying to get rid of those if we as testers are the only people responding to those external needs, because it's not helping the team move forward. So with agile testing, the way that we adapt testing to any environment, regardless of whether it's waterfall, agile, scrum, some sort of hybrid, whatever we're doing, we need to understand testing. And that's why we've had a problem with agile testing, simply because people haven't understood testing. So they've tried to carry forward all the stuff that they did on a traditional waterfall project, all the templates, all the processes, because they didn't really understand testing. None of that was testing. We need to understand the essence of testing. Now, this might seem bad, but it's not intended to be bad. Essentially, with an agile process, we're making this up as we go along. And what that means is we're responding to the needs and changes in the environment based on our experience and lessons learned from other people, from things that we see in the world, from conference talks, from articles. We're pooling all this in, we're doing experiments, we're seeing what works. Now, that sounds bad, but that's fundamentally the essence of psychotherapy. It's the essence of lean manufacturing. I mean, this is the reason why I study things like cybernetics. There's a small subset of my cybernetics library, because cybernetics is all about systems and teleological based systems with a purpose, how people respond in it, how you use feedback. Cybernetics, massively important in terms of understanding systems and testing and agile. It's why I study systems theory and systems thinking, because we're working with systems, we're building systems as a system. We as a team are a system of development. System stuff is really important to understanding agile and testing. Lean manufacturing, all the stuff on lean manufacturing, we get told, well, we shouldn't have factory approaches to testing, but there's a lot we can learn from manufacturing industries that are lean based, who are trying to adapt to what's going on the ground, who are trying to make their processes more effective, who are trying to avoid all the waste. We talk about Kanban processes. Kanban came from supermarkets and lean manufacturing. That's where we go to understand how people improve things, because there's nothing wrong with a standardized process if it helps us learn and if we're flexible in changing it. So all of these things put together help. So whilst it sounds like making it up as we go along is a bad thing, we're making it up as we go along because we are heavily invested in studying other areas that work, that deal with complex dynamic systems, and we learn from those. So in terms of understanding testing, we need to understand what is testing for, right? What are we trying to achieve when we test in this environment? Because there's lots of ways of looking at testing. You can go, we're just trying to find the problems. We're trying to prevent problems, which means you get involved in different ways in the process. We have to look at what models of testing that we find value in. So we might model testing as feedback. So that means, who are we passing feedback into? Are we acting on the feedback? Is it positive or negative feedback? Are we attenuating different signals? Are we so that people don't notice them? Are we amplifying signals? Are we doing that with the right signals to get the right feedback back? Are we doing this as part of an assurance process to convince people that things are in a certain state? Are we certifying it? Therefore, it has to meet certain criteria mandatory on an ongoing basis. That would change how we test. Do we value and model exploration in there because we're trying to see what else we might not have thought about, what else it can do, and should it do that or not, to make decisions on it? What are the risks? All of these things change how we approach the testing. And it comes down to what models of testing we value on that project and in that team. And we have to understand that testing has never been about the tester. Testing has always been about the process that we use, the approach that we take, and the results that we get back. And Agile in particular isn't about a tester does the testing. It is about testing as a verb and process on the project. And if testers hold that close and say, we do the testing, you're not harnessing the flexibility and freedom that you can have on an Agile project. It's important to understand how we test, right? Because fundamentally, when we test, we build and compare models to the system. And as we do that, we learn more, which changes our models. Requirement models, acceptance criteria models, non-functional requirement models, certification requirements, assurance, whatever, all those are models they feed in. We use them to explore the system in different ways with using the skills and techniques that we have at our disposal. So learning how to model well, learning better skills, learning technical knowledge are all massively important. And that's the essence of testing, and that hasn't changed. It's just that when we did waterfall structured testing, we had a lot of trappings on top of that. So Agile testing is new only in the sense that it's not a templated approach. You don't come into Agile and go, right, we're an Agile project, now we do a test strategy, a one-page test strategy, because it's Agile, and our process is da-da-da-da-da. It evolves. It changes based on the needs of the project, based on the skill sets of the people there, based on the current set of dynamics, and we expect those to change. We can't shoehorn in old tools and processes and mandates and procedures and templates and documentation and meetings after meeting after meeting. That won't work. We can only succeed on Agile by understanding and harnessing the essence of testing. And that's what we as testers have to learn. That's the value that we add in Agile projects, the essence of testing. And sometimes we're the only people that can implement that until we teach other people how to do it properly. We're trying to avoid waste. All those trappings that you've brought from your other projects probably are waste and are not required on an Agile project. So we have to understand that. We're trying to avoid it. That's why understanding lean manufacturing can help, because it's about avoiding waste a lot of the time. And we're trying fundamentally to work effectively as part of a system of development. That's really what is driving us as part of an Agile approach. So we are trying to adapt to the processes in place. We tackle risk, lots of risk, process risks, the way that we actually build the system. We might change our test approach based on that, the actual product risks that we're prepared to cope with, the technical way that we're building the system, where we can test, how we can inject data, what tools we need to work with, all of these things change how we approach our testing. We want to keep things as lightweight, as lean, as fast as we can to avoid trappings, but that doesn't mean we neglect the persistent mechanisms in our communication process. That doesn't mean we don't write things down. It just means that we write down the things that are important. And testing fundamentally is a verb, it's not a noun. We're not going out and getting some Agile testing. We are testing well and effectively on an Agile project. That's Agile testing. So if this video has been useful, I'll do some more videos on Agile testing. So subscribe to the channel to make sure that you get that information, and leave a comment. Tell me what you think. What other questions should we be answering about Agile testing? What other questions do you have? Let me know. We'll see if we can answer those as well.